Good afternoon, everyone. At approximately 9 a.m. this morning, the state police commenced the execution of a search warrant on the property of 65 Shoddy Mill Road in Bolton. This was subsequent to the violation of a protective order stemming from domestic violence charges and the failure to surrender firearms from that resident. We utilized extensive resources and assistance from the FBI and some of our municipal partners. And there's a lot of resources out there, and that's because of the extensive property. It's a very large parcel with a lot of property there and a lot of buildings. But I want to assure the public that they're safe. There is no concern for the safety of the public at this time.
So are you looking for this gentleman?
We are not looking for this gentleman. We are looking for firearms that were not surrendered as a violation of that protective order.
And can you talk about how many firearms and what you're looking for at this point?
We're not sure exactly how many firearms. Probably 20 to 21 firearms.
How long do you expect to be out there? This is still very active right now?
It's a very active investigation. We expect it's going to be an extended time frame that may take more than 24 hours.
So do you think these are hidden in different places? This is not something you could walk in and find all of them there?
That's hard to say. That's why we have extensive resources out there and our federal and local partners to assist us so that we can make this an expeditious execution.
We saw the bomb squad vehicle and several armored vehicles. Did you anticipate some kind of potential standoff of some sort?
You know, these things are always a concern, but not necessarily in this case. We take every precaution for the safety of the public, the neighbors, and for the safety of our personnel as well.
And can you say when this protective order was violated and, like, you know, kind of when this all began and how we got to this point?
This is over the last couple weeks, so I don't have the particular date in mind. But this is over the course of the last 2 weeks.
Colonel, hadn't you already seized some firearms from Mr. Benigni?
That's correct, we did, and that was a few weeks ago. What followed after that was more information that developed that led us to believe that the firearms were still on the property.
So you seized some firearms, but you had information that there were many more potentially there on the property?
That's correct. There are 21 registered firearms for the resident. Some of those firearms were seized at that time a couple weeks ago, but since the bulk of them have not been located and some intelligence information was developed to indicate they could still be on the property, that's what brings us back here today.
Can you say what types of firearms were seized and what types you're looking for?
That I don't have available right now.
Long guns and handguns, though?
Correct, both.
Are you releasing the name of this person at this time?
I'd rather not go into further details. It's still an active investigation.
Have you talked to him?
We did a couple weeks ago.
But not today?
Not today. That's correct.
Is he in custody?
He is not.
He's not in custody.
He posted bond, is my understanding.
That's correct. He's out on bond right now.
But not at the home?
No.
Is anyone at the home right now?
No one is at the home except for the state police and our partners that are helping us. To be honest with you, I'm not sure who resides there. Okay. I know there are a few other residents.
There are a few other
That's correct.
You mentioned the public. I mean, is there anything other than that there's a large police presence? Is that kind of why you wanted to let people know that, you know, that you're out there?
That's correct. It's, you know, it's concerning to the public, and we want to assure them that that it is safe at this time. Again, the added personnel is so that we could expeditiously search the property. And that, you know, with all the weapons that were in play, we wanted to ensure that it was going to be safe for our personnel and for the neighborhood.
There were thousands of rounds of ammunition seized a couple weeks ago, is my understanding. Are you guys looking for ammunition as well?
Yes. I mean, you know, there were seized a couple weeks ago in that original search warrant. But with firearms comes ammunition, so certainly they will be seized as well if they're found today.
Do you have any concerns about explosives, Colonel, or anything like that?
I don't think there's immediate information for that. We always take those precautions when we enter property and we do these executions, nothing that concerns us at this time, no.
And can you say what kind of resources, equipment you have there looking for the firearms? I mean, do you have canines?
We have a variety of personnel there. We have specially trained canines. They're firearms detection canines, the first of its kind here in Connecticut and in New England. We have electronic device detection canines. We have major crime detectives that are assisting us. We have tactical personnel from both the state police and from the FBI, the Bolton Resident Trooper's Office. That's most of it.
And last question, was your new information at all associated with any kind of threat or anything that he had made, Mr. Committee?
Still an active investigation. Yeah. We also have bomb techs that are on scene as well to take every precaution.
Is it fair to say that this is a bigger situation that you guys have dealt with? I mean, do you do this often with this big of a crew?
Not necessarily, but in these circumstances, we're taking every precaution.
The resident trooper, has he frequented this house before? Have there been incidents at this house before?
I know there have been prior calls to service at this residence. Troop K personnel have been here before. That's correct.
More than just the past few weeks?
Yes, over time. I'm not sure what time frame, but there have been. But I just want to let everybody know at this time that the public is safe. There is no concern right now to the immediate public. We've taken every precaution. It is a safe scene. But as we develop new information, we will share that as it is developed. Thank you.
Thank you.